It's the third stop of the ASA Pro Tour. We're in Buffalo, New York. Brian Aragon's already won the first two stops of the season. He's trying to make it three in a row, but Brian, you had a tough time in the prelims. What are you going to do in the finals?
I just need to land my 450 top, so that was the main part. And I just need to land all my tricks smooth.
Yeah, and he's also got to worry about Stefan Alfano, Randy Spicer, Cameron Card, and a whole slew of other guys. And we'll see how it all plays out in the ASA Pro Tour.
We're just outside of majestic Niagara Falls on the shores of Lake Erie at LaSalle Park, and we're ready for Inline Street. It's the third regular season stop of the ASA Pro Tour. In this show, we'll hang with the USD team during the day and party with some locals at night to expose their city. Also, we turn Davey Blair loose on the street course. He'll bring us closer to the action.
Oh, he just did a little flip on the bank. That's amazing.
Brian Aragon and Stefan Alfano have been battling all season long. Stefan's been very progressive on the street course, but so far Brian's won two events in a row.
Brian is amazing. He's a really good tech, go big skater, and he's definitely one of the big up and coming skaters. His technical level is as high as anyone's. His air level is as high as anyone's. Everything is at the peak. I think I'm having such a good year because I took a year off of school and I've just been able to concentrate all my time on skating. And I've been skating both street and park just equal. So it's just bringing my skating up because I can do all the tricks on the rails and I'm able to still do all my tricks on the ramp too. So it's kind of like the better you can skate both, the better you'll do in a contest.
Brian Aragon, he's looking really good. He can hold down pretty much any course because whether it's all about launches or it's all about grinds, like he's got them both. Like, and normally that's what your two things consist of is like gaps or airs, you know? And then you have like your grinds, you know? And he's got airs and grinds, so it's like, it's really hard to hold him down, but he might have to go down on this one.
Well, as this one is about to get started, each skater will get two 65 second runs and only the better run in the finals counts.
Brian Aragon coming in, Brian Colorado. Kid won both contests of the year, going for his third. Brian Aragon, you're going to see some big technical tricks from this kid. He's amazing, just check him out.
Brian Aragon going to start out on the rolling as he heads for a launch box. And why not when you've got the launch moves that Brian Aragon's got? Big 900 to start it out.
Yeah, he's really the complete skater, going right to the rail.
You see Brian Aragon doing the biggest trick for a simple fact that, like this trick right here, that's the best trick in his run. When you can do that, you know you're set. That's why he's won both contests in a row, going for his third. Looking good so far.
Brian making good use of the coursing, a lot of obstacles, and mixing up those spins and grinds so well.
He's doing what he has to. 30 seconds.
Still got 30 seconds, and he's packed a lot of tricks. Disaster Royale, man. This kid's always on his feet. He's like a cat. You never see him go down. Hopefully I didn't jinx him because I'll feel like a jerk.
Brian really knows his line. He knows exactly where he wants to go. And check him out, charging to get a good finishing trick.
Oh, true alley-oop unity, man. That's crazy. See, that's the street skating aspect of it. You got all the street skating tricks off of ramps. It's amazing. Not many people could do it.
There's two ways to spin this 360 into the far side sole. You can either spin towards the rail or away from it. Brian goes the hard way, away from the rail. It's called a hurricane.
And rewarded in 91, a super high score.
Carlos Pianowski next up. They call him Hardcore Brazil because he's hardcore. Skating, life, everything. He's hardcore. Here he comes. He can't even hear what's going on right now. He has headphones on, so.
Carlos is known for big stunts. People expect him to get wild when he's on the park course.
Fakey backflip. One of the only people who does it. It's amazing. That trick's really hard.
A big 540 transfer over the hip into the bank. And look at how he charges around with reckless abandon, crashing into innocent bystanders. Alley-oop Sol transfer across that small coping box.
Yeah, he's got so many different things figured out. And check out the intensity. Everything is intense for him.
He's so much fun to watch. He loves to get the crowd into it. He's always dramatic.
Just like Brian Aragon, he's putting best trick tricks he should use in the best trick contest, into his run. That's the difference between him and a lot of people. He's crazy. He's got 10 seconds left.
Carlos is definitely not afraid to take risks in big contests. It's why he's had so much success. You can't be afraid. And here he goes, 270 into the frontside Farfenugan, down the handrail. Now coming up that square handrail with the topside Sol. Very good run for Carlos Pianowski.
My boy, Carlos, how do you feel about your run?
Good. I liked my first run.
Really?
And I did pretty good, so
next run's gonna go crazy.
Gonna be crazy.
For Brazil.
Some crazy coming up.
Slayer.
Oh yeah. Slayer.
Carlos Pianowski, next up.
Told you he's crazy.
Well, when we come back, we're gonna step it up another notch. Don't go anywhere, we got a lot more. The Mobile Skate Park Series is brought to you by Yoo-Hoo. Yoo-Hoo or you don't. By Nestle Butterfinger. Break out of the ordinary and into a Butterfinger. And by the LG Action Sports Championship. Go to actionsportschampionships.com for all the information on the year-end championships for skateboarding, BMX, freestyle motocross, and inline skating. Welcome back to the third regular season stop of the ASA Pro Tour here, part of the Mobile Skate Park Series. We're going to get right back to the competition and recap some round one.
Cameron Carr just stepped into the house. What do you think about your next run? Anything special you want to tell us before you do it?
Yeah, it's a secret.
Well, what is no secret is that Cameron Carr is very technical. A bit of a tech whiz. He had a solid run, but only earned an 84.25. He'll look to improve in the second round.
Bobby Tatiishi, a rookie on the Pro Tour, coming out with a 900. That's a big boy move.
Hey, you're known as one of those guys who does creative tricks and no one else does. Is that for any reason? Or just...
I just like to be able to do tricks that no one else in the runs do.
Out of Bel Air, Maryland, another rookie having a very good competition. He qualified third after the prelims.
So, this is my sponsor.
Johanny,
Johanny Velasquez is my sponsor.
And another rookie, also in the runnings for Rookie of the Year, Richie Velasquez.
After the first run, Randy Spizer's in third, Hardcore Brazil in second, and Brian Aragon in great standing to make it three victories in a row. Richie Velasquez has got some ground to make up in round two, but he's going to take us through Trictionary.
This is Lake Erie, and this is the street course. I'm Richie Velasquez from Woodward West, and I'm going to break down how to do a flat spin over a hip. Check it out. What I do is when I shoot for the flat spin, I make sure I get good speed. I make sure I go on the corner of the hip, throw a backflip, and I look over my shoulder and my body follows the rotation. And as I'm rotating, I see the coping and I spot my landing, and it's a pretty safe trick. That was a flat spin over a hip. I'm out.
Thank you, Mr. Richie Velasquez. That's why he's the camp director at Woodward West. Well, heading back and taking a look at some skaters from run number two, Brian Aragon came out blazing again. Didn't get quite the score he got the first time around, but an 89, very respectable. Carlos Pianowski with that go-for-broke attitude, unfortunately, sometimes it just doesn't work out. He'll stick with his first run score. And that means that the pressure and opportunity now sits on Randy Spizer. Davey sat down with him right before the competition to talk about what it would take to beat Aragon.
You loosened his bolts. Just admit you loosened his bolts.
A little bit. I put
his frame's kind of wiggly now.
Rubber cement in his bearings.
It works good. He's going a little slower out there.
In all seriousness, what Randy's going to need to beat Brian Aragon is some excitement. Fakie 540, and Randy's always good for at least a few stunts in these runs. It's just a matter of landing them all. Consistency, of course, plays a huge role.
Hops on the ledge. That thing's waist high. I can't believe he's doing it. Throw it out. Getting his britches a pull up. Doing his little good luck charm. True Spin Royale. We saw Brian Aragon do it. It's becoming a... So 2 years ago, that was the best trick winner. Now people are doing it in their runs. It's amazing how much skating progresses. And Randy's one of those guys progressing it for the last 10 years. Big toe tap 540. He fell on his first run on it, so he's having obviously a better second run.
And he has nice hair. Did you see his highlights? Did you see his highlights? So good. Look at
him. Going for a big chick. Probably disaster con gun.
Oh!
That's gangster.
You don't see that. He's going to run.
Randy doing everything he needs to do in this run, throwing some big moves and sticking them until that moment.
Randy Spicer ends his run. Kind of not what he wanted, not the energy, but... Here he comes to say a few words. Roadhouse.
How you doing, man?
What's good?
A little tired.
A little tired? What happened? You don't even smoke cigarettes, man.
I don't know. I did all my tricks, but I fell at the end,
It's all good. You mad? You glad? What?
Happy.
You're crazy. This kid's crazy. He's Roadhouse. He's a hot dude. Right. Justin Timberlake, what? You got the handshake?
Hey. That puts Randy in third place. Putting a great skating run together takes more than just landing your tricks. It takes style. The same goes for B-boys and the moves that they do. Saji's going to break down one of the basic moves that you see B-boys doing in a breakdance routine. Once you get it wired, you got to give it style. That's our focus in this week's Paul Mitchell Style and Performance.
You see a lot of complicated moves here at the Yard presented by Mixwell at the Mobile Skate Park Series, but they all start with the six step, which is the foundation of B-boying. How you start is you start on your hands and your feet, and you take your left leg, step it in front of your right leg. Then next, number two, you bring your right leg up and drive your shin into the back of your left knee. And then three, you bring your left leg up in front, and now you're sort of in a crab position. Imagine that there's a mirror between your body, so the next three steps are gonna be exactly like the first three steps that you did. So bring your right leg around in front, driving your knee into the shin of your right leg. That should look exactly like step number two. Step behind with your left leg, and now step behind with your right leg, and you're at six. And when you put it all together, it looks something like this.
Style, we're going to take a look at some of the style makers in the sport. It's Team USD when we come back, and Stefano Funnel will get one more shot at Brian Aragon. Welcome back to the Mobile Skate Park Series. We're at LaSalle Park in Buffalo, New York. And remember, these shows are on every Friday from 4 to 5 on Fox Sports Net. Tell your friends. There's a lot more to skating than just the competition side. We're going to take a look right now at some of the trendsetters, the guys who have been the stalwarts in the sport. It's Team USD.
What up, Tito? Bring them up to speed.
Fly with me, fly with me, don't lie, vibe with me, don't ride, by shy, ride your vibe when you with me. This is Ripley's, believe it or not, hip hop. We can talk about it later or not, but die. Come fly with your baby boy, with the new baby Floyd Patterson head, you off of Madison Fifth Avenue, passing through the defense that bad and true. I'ma give you a
That's a big accomplishment to have.
Big accomplishment.
Kids out there.
Been through a lot of injuries, ain't nothing new, but it's good to know that USD has got my back throughout it all, and I'll be back for it again, you know what I'm saying?
I've been around here, my man. Get your hands up. 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 Get your hands up, get your hands up. A style of consistent, of getting
getting drunk and lifted. Caps get twisted, but back to gap statistics. Was realistic, not to backtrack, you missed it. Insisted, we bring back the fast ballistics. We did it, and spit it, intertwined like when it fitted. Then fitted, you know I did it when the venom is fitted. I hit it on the head of a dime instead of a rhyme. I am
USD is street skating. USD doesn't make recreational skates, hockey skates, ice skates. For the love, we just do what we make profit for what we do, street skating, and it gives people variety.
They're not only great street skaters, but great contest skaters like the next skater, Stefan Alfano.
Basically, Stefan Alfano is number one in the world for a reason. Qualified number one in this contest. Number one ranked in the world. He's got the biggest chicks and the most technical chicks. You're going to see it right now. Paris, France. Here he goes, dropping in. Big corkscrew 720. You don't see anyone else doing it because it's crazy. Transfer. Truth to talk. Oh, wow, he saved it. Truth to talk, though. And that's what he wanted. He's really mad at himself right now.
Up on the wall, porn star to Royale, and then Royale onto the handrail. Very creative use of the course. Now working his way towards the down handrail.
Yeah, that's all I can say about this kid. Is the biggest chicks in the contest. Barely coming out on that one. He's got about 30 seconds left, and he's already done more tricks than half the people in the finals.
That is true. Tons of tricks, but he's not landed all of them completely clean, so it looks like he's definitely going to fall short of that first place mark.
People on tour can't really talk to him unless they're front. They speak French, but they have more respect for him than a lot of guys, basically because he does the biggest tricks. He'll find the biggest trick on the course, and he laces it every single time. Disaster Royale. The kid's so seasoned. From Paris, France, the kid's amazing.
Well, a great run for Stefan Alfano. Let's take another look at how he started off. The huge corkscrew 720, grabbed on and held it almost the entire way. And then here's the creativity. Comes up porn star to Royale to drop Royale down the rail on the backside of the wall. And that run, while it was good, he lacked the consistency. He'll do no better than fourth.
Last year when I would come, I would do tricks that I knew I could land every time. And when I went home, I really wasn't satisfied with the way I skated. So this year, I'm throwing out hard tricks in my run and hoping for the best. And it's been working out well lately.
Well, congratulations to Brian Aragon. It is working out well. He's throwing huge tricks and lacing the course week after week. Brian Aragon looking like a true champion once again. Now it's time for the Yoo-Hoo Best Bracks. Many skaters came out throwing big tricks and paying the price, but the rookie, Richie Velasquez, goes down and earns this week's Yoo-Hoo's Best Racks. Don't you go anywhere, they're just heating up. When we come back, it's the best trick competition, and some local ladies are going to show us the nightlife here in Buffalo. The Mobile Skate Park Series is brought to you by Nintendo, born to play. By Lee Dungarees, when action calls, Buddy Lee answers it. And by Paul Mitchell. Paul Mitchell's all about style, your style. Welcome back to the Mobile Skate Park Series here in beautiful Buffalo, New York.
Hi, welcome to the Red Room. My name is Gina, and I'm the bartender of the month, and I want to welcome to Buffalo, New York. This is pretty much the hottest pub in Buffalo, New York, which we have all different themes. Why don't you come out and follow me?
The only place where the action was more wild than in the Buffalo nightlife was on the street course in the sick trick contest. Saw all different kinds of tricks. Walt Austin came out with a creative grind to Cess-like combo. And Hormice was killing the disaster rail with all different variations. And Richie Velasquez even came out with something fun and creative as he enlisted Randy Roadhouse Pfizer to help him with the Monkey Clamp 540. Stefan Alfano brought out one of his signature huge transfers, clearing about 12 feet or more on the 540 transfer. Brian Aragon, of course, with the cool consistency on the Hurricane topside sole and spinning 540 out of it. But the trick of the contest was performed by Cameron Card. The attempts were brutal, but by the time Cameron Card finally landed his disaster sole, everyone knew that the contest was over and that Cameron Card had won the best trick contest.
Hotel accommodations provided by the Holiday Inn, downtown Buffalo. Special thanks to One Source Marketing, 103.3 The Edge, Wild 101, The Buffalo News, Fox 29, the WB 49, and the City of Buffalo. Don't forget to catch all the world's best action sports stars at the LG Action Sports Championship. It's at Fairplex in Pomona, California, November 15th to the 23rd, the year-end championships for skateboarding, BMX, Freestyle Moto X, and inline skating. Go to actionsportschampionships.com for all the details.
Thanks for coming out. Have fun. Hope you guys are watching.